Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to South Open Dashboard Championships 2020. We are very excited to be here. It's beautiful, it's crazy, it's madness, because the competition is full and it's a final competition of 2020. But tonight...
Tonight we're going to watch the final of the American Smooth Championships. It was a quarterfinal from the beginning. Couples have been dancing two rounds already. Yes. And now this is the last call for the last six couples out there. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy American Smooth Final.
This production is brought to you by Motion Capture Dance and Ballroom Backstage.
Six couples recalled for the final round. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the dance floor your first finalist, Dancing Waltz, from Florida, couple 141, Roman Nahasyan and Camila Detkinema.
Thank you.
couple 174, Sean Minatel Don. Thank you. And now your next finalist, dancing tango from Florida, couple 194, Dimitri Zamiyama and Arina Sokolova.
Together, because we never gave up and we always gave an opportunity to each other.
The energy was just unbelievable.
It was beautiful for me to see that, and talking to people as well is to realize that every single person in that ballroom is truly in love with ballroom dancing.
Absolutely.
And they're truly passionate about it.
Yes, it's just it's a joy to see. I'm glad to be surrounded by people who have that passion, who have that drive. I mean, it's just a great crowd, and I can't wait for everything to be open up again. I think we're gonna drive so many more people to the ballroom world. I think we all, the core of people has such a love and such an energy for that. We're just gonna be like a magnet and drive everybody in. So I'm just looking forward to what comes next year. And, South Open, it's the last event this year, 2020, there weren't many. And we just to see everybody, it's like a big family reunion.
That's true.
Here.
That's a big reunion, yes.
Reunion.
And overall, the competition, as always, it's Sid's attention to detail, it's for me is amazing. And you see behind us, gorgeous ballroom. I honestly love the way he does the ballroom. It's always very festive.
It's a beautiful Christmas and holiday theme.
Yes.
And he has, he really pays attention to detail, and he has a beautiful way to make it stylish, but also like a wonderland, like a winter wonderland. So it's just beautiful.
This production is brought to you by Motion Capture Dance and Ballroom Backstage.
You said, we talked to you before during the day, and you said that pandemic kind of changed everything. You got some rest, and I can see that you won the Rising Stars Pro Smooth. Your feelings? Excited, tired, excited to dance tonight?
Personally, for me, this pandemic situation changed my life like crazy. But it's okay. In positive side, because I met Dima, and I start to dance smooth.
Where?
Here in Florida.
On a lockdown, I don't know.
Yeah, So I started to dance smooth, and it's absolutely.
What did you dance before? Hold on.
Latin.
Latin. Oh, yeah. I love you. And that's it. Okay.
It's really new for me.
Okay.
New country, new feelings, new dress, long dress.
How long are you in America?
Since February.
Since February.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
This year.
Yes. Everything changed. Yes. True. Yeah.
Yes.
And we're already engaged.
Yeah. And that's why our lives so changed in this pandemic time.
They had a fun pandemic time. They had a fun lockdown. Okay.
Yeah.
How did it happen? Hold on. I did know that you guys are dating. So how did it happen?
Because in the beginning when we started dancing, we were like, okay, serious relationship, dance relationship, nothing about like love. Like you my partner, I'm your partner. That's it. And after like
suddenly it happened. Like
yes. I'm asking her. Are you okay, with my wife?
Okay, okay, okay.
Say,
okay.
Yes.
What happened? It. Like literally, like he just proposed?
No, I wasn't ready for that, and I believe that he wasn't ready for that. No.
I don't plan to say this for her.
Yeah.
This is just one moment it came to
from
me.
This, like, yeah, like,
yes.
Yeah.
I'm super happy actually because it's you know, I know him for quite a bit now. Actually 9 years. So I said first time I saw
seven.
you came seven? You came to Fred Astaire.
Yes.
And he was looking for a partner for a long time, and finally you're here and I see you guys dancing, you're winning, that's awesome.
Yeah.
It's our second competition.
Yeah.
When was the first one?
Grand National.
Oh okay, yes. Congratulations guys. So
Ohio Star Bowl was supposed to be our fourth year to start dancing together. So it's also that time.
Okay.
Yeah, we celebrate our anniversary, the danceversary there. But
in general, when we just start dancing, some of our teachers said you will see results in minimum 2 years to 3-4 years. This will be a result of developing something.
And what did they say about
said,
your
no,
case
you,
per se?
We're gonna do faster and you know, we are better, we're more talented.
We're like,
and
we're
gonna
it
do
now.
It. But as we feel now, they actually were right.
Yeah.
You know, to develop product, refined product to what we want and the product, what we believe and what we do. We try to be something different than other people and it's very hard. Especially find something in the choreography. We watch different kind of videos,
different style of dancing, not
you know,
always related.
Even hip-hop.
Yeah.
Sometimes I watch hip-hop and go, oh, this was a cool move, you know.
That's what it was in your foxtrot, guys.
Yes, this is what I did. And like we do a lot of, Galina like actually Russian ballet. She's a big fan of certain ballerinas she follow. And she always show me, I go, did you see that? Did you see that? We can try.
During the pandemic, I made Roman watch a couple of full ballet.
Actually, it was live. I was watching, I cannot say I'm not a fan of ballet. It's just not my thing. I like
no,
different things.
I can see that you're totally a fan.
Yes. But it was very hard. It was very hard for me. Galina in Russia, in the Bolshoi Theater, one of the best ballet scene in the whole world, the best ballerina, prima ballerina dance there. There was a translating live from Bolshoi during that pandemic, was no audience. And we was watching how it was very hard for them to dance with no audience at all. But it was fantastic. It was fantastic inspiration to see people doing that and the way they're doing and the way of their professionalism was just incredible. And this make us go even further, you know, and work on ourselves like never before. Like Galina, for example, she wake up at 6:30, 7 o'clock and run every day. No.
Every day. So
every day.
Sometimes he thinks it's every, but I just run to the store to get
I just
new
sleep
shoes.
More. I sleep more a little bit.
Okay, it's actually very inspirational, guys. Thank you so much.
I always knew I'm gonna come back to the dance floor.
My goal to be the best of me, the best version of myself. I want to dance my best dance, classy, sensually, a little bit crazy. I like to close my eyes when I'm dancing. It helps me to feel.
It took me a pretty long time to start to feel that we become a couple.
But at the moment I understood that we like got our partnership, that when we settled our goals and like actually started to listen to each other.
In our first competition, I started to feel that we are really a couple when we sign in front of everybody. I can't actually explain what exactly happened, but in the moment when we step on the dance floor together, on the competition dance floor together, it's something clicked. They're just, okay, now we are a real couple. Right before the first round, the concentration was on my partner.
I wanted to dance for my partner. I wanted him to dance for me.
To dance together and to realize nothing around is nothing is existing.
Right now, they are warmed up, they are ready. Lots of people here, everybody's ready to dance. Exciting atmosphere. Yes. So here we go.
This is competition actually is very, very special for few reasons. First of all, it's 2020 and we didn't have so many competition during this year. And another part is, this is a special competition for Yulia and Sergey. Before this final, that's already was announced on Facebook because this is all recorded. Before this final, I would say they are retiring. They're retiring as a partnership. So not as a dancing, but as a partnership. After the final, you will see the interview with them. So as of right now,
stay tuned, watch that interview. And ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the final of the American Smooth Championship. Enjoy.
This production is brought to you by Motion Capture Dance and Ballroom Backstage.
Thanks to the dancer now and our finalists in this Open Provincial American Smooth Championship. Your first dances waltz, music please. Thank you, competitors. And places once again, couples your next dance is tango. Music, please. Victoria. from Georgia, 1155 Sergei Samshinsky and Yulia Besarov. From Florida, 1174 Jean and Adele Don. From Florida, 1194 Dmitry Zabiyama and Arena Sokolova. And from Arizona, 2232 Alexei Potlatsky and Anastasia Zhuchenko. Competitors. And places once again doubles your final dance. Viennese Waltz. And music leaders.
Not being on the floor for since California Open.
Well, it's a sad and happy in the very same time. Happy because we still get to dance competitions.
Yes, this was very refreshing. Yeah.
Even it's very last one, but we still did it. Sad that actually it is only our fourth competition in the United States for entire year, right?
True. Yeah.
Yeah, we did only four, right?
Yeah, we actually had
including the South Open.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
So it's hard time in Los Angeles and in California because not
it's very
like,
challenging, yes.
Yeah, it's not like in Florida, everything is shut down, everything closed. We don't really have a space or place to practice or do anything about dancing.
I mean, I've seen your driveway, so it's pretty spacious.
It also goes down, so you can roll
keep
down.
Things interesting.
Actually, I think, Nick said it, we had a really crazy year planned when we started it in January and February and started with an Asian tour that got canceled as we arrived to Japan. That was our intro, right? And then we came back to the United States and of course everything went into this lockdown mode. And this is really great that we had an opportunity to finish the year with this competition. I think we made a lot of discoveries on how creative we really are by teaching Zoom classes from a living room.
Yes, I saw your lecture, it was pretty interesting by the way. Yeah.
Yes, so we're working with a group of people most of whom have a very different flooring in a house. So some have carpet, some have hardwood, some have tile, right? So we have to, of course, nobody lives with a partner. We have a luxury of living with a partner. So we can still dance, even as you mentioned, in a driveway.
And we got a distressor. Actually, Victoria got a distressor. A small black one.
I adopted a cat. He's very good. But that's not the point. Okay. I was talking about,
coming back to the dancing.
I was talking about the Zoom classes. It was phenomenal because first when we said, okay, we have to go online because everything is shut down, so we have to kind of carry on and make sure that our students are engaged and they're staying interested and all that stuff. And we first thought, okay, well, we just go through the syllabus. But then you slowly realize that taking a basic twinkle is already moving you out of the view of the camera.
In your case, yes.
Well, in most people's case, I think it depends on the size of the living room, because we had audiences joining us from New York. You know, New York apartment's not very big.
No, absolutely.
Yeah, so we went very creative. I was doing a lot of contemporary dancing. We were doing the exploration of our body, you know, learning different muscle groups, joints, how they work together. And of course, when I come up with the stuff, it's rather girly. But Nick was such a great sport. He did all of that. He did every crazy idea I had.
Yeah, I was sexy.
No, you,
I was on
really
fire.
Great, but it was fun to see how something that is like maybe even in the way feminine, because it's of like soft and rolling joints, how he would interpret it as his own. He didn't exactly do what I said. It was always Nick's own version, but it was really cool to see how he can learn.
I cannot imagine Nick doing something really feminine. Like, seriously, I cannot.
No,
like,
well, no, you made it look very good. It's different. It actually looked completely different, but everybody was doing great.
Coming back to you guys. So, besides that, like tonight, right? I know it's still after 10 months. How did it feel?
9 months, 10 months, yeah. How did it
feel? It's 8.5 months, actually.
Okay, you better.
It felt great being on a dance floor. It felt great that we actually have a live audience, because you know, like some other competitions were allowed to go on.
Spit it out.
No, I'm good, I'm good. Go ahead.
It's challenging. What do you want us to say? It's crazy.
I don't need to say anything.
I'm honestly gonna say how it is. United States divided into 50 different little locations, and some had very little effect because the studios were open. And guys, in LA, the studios have closed down in March and they're still closed. And this is a truth. When the governor made an announcement that we allowed the gyms to open, he forgot to make a notation about the dance studios. So the dance studios never open up. And now we went back in the lockdown. So it feels like that. It feels like you're a little prisoner.
The summary of what Victoria just said, follow a bounce in the hallway and the follow a bounce on the floor feels really different.
I'm glad to hear that. I hope so. You know what? I hope so. It's okay. Anyway, good to see you. Very nice. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the final competition for 2020. This is South Open.
21, please.
Thank you, guys. You told me the news, and I'm actually trying to digest it, actually. So, as they told me, they're finishing their dance career together.
Together.
And now you have to explain it to them. I'm not responsible anymore.
Together. Like, not one and one, but together.
Well, I think it was a long, well-thought decision.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, we danced together for 18 years. Mm-hmm. Longer than anybody that I know.
Yeah.
And there are certain things that we tried still to do together, and we felt maybe we should try it with other people, you know, just to find some new feelings.
That sounded wrong.
Okay. It's a good thing that, guys, I'm wearing a mask, because you should see my face right now. You know what? If I gonna tell it to my wife, she's gonna divorce me. You know, so anyway, on a serious note, like seriously, guys, I saw you crying during the final. Not during the final, like during the last dance. Obviously, that's a sad moment, and I want to hear what's right here, guys.
We had truly great journey together, with all ups and downs.
All your results, yes.
Really enjoyed it. Like, I'm glad I haven't done it with anyone else, but with her. But right now, we feel it's a really right decision to save everything good that we had in this partnership, yeah. And not tamper with it any longer, you know?
I'm not gonna ask you, and we give the respect of not asking why.
Yeah, I think I will give the respect. Very personal to
yes,
us.
Yes, I will give
know?
The respect not to ask you why.
But I think every single couple out there that dance quite a long while will understand us really good.
What I want to ask you is, since from your experience, what lessons would you want a new generation, like you told me there is a younger generation is coming, what lessons you want them to learn out of your partnerships? If there's something you have to say.
I think patience and be open-minded and listen, you know, to each other, what the other person has to say.
I am listening to you right now.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that was the reason why we lasted so long, you know, because we never gave up and we always gave an opportunity to each other.
Also, a big suggestion that I would give myself if I would be like 16, starting from beginning everything else, to understand that the problem is never in one person. It's always in two people, always.
Especially in partnership, like
dancing. Dance partnership, no matter what conflict is, I always feel it's an issue of two people. And once you understand that, it's already halfway solved. Because like blaming each other is the worst thing ever.
You know, it's really warms my heart, guys, to see you and to know you. And I did a bunch of the videos for you guys as a memory, and I hope it's going to be the great memory for you. I always will happy to have you here, always to do something for you. And I'm really deeply sad
that I will not.
Yeah. Yes.
Or maybe
yes.
No partners at all. Everything is possible.
Everything is possible. So
but
as of right now,
we both have desire to dance, for sure.
We all passionate about dancing, and I can see that your wish is still there. So I hopefully.
Yeah.
So.
Hopefully we'll be back on that floor. You know. Yeah.
All right, guys. I love you so much. So enjoy the retirement as of right now for a couple of days.
For a couple of weeks.
Couple of weeks. Okay, guys. So guys, as of right now, they are finishing their partnership. They stopped dancing as of right now. So this is South Open Dance World Championships.
Text her on Facebook.
Text her on Facebook.